Did you know that you can actually still extend your C drive even if the extend volume option is grayed out, but you have unallocated space that you can use? I actually didn't know how to do this up until this point, and I came across this issue a few weeks ago when I made the video showing you how to install Windows without a USB flash drive. In that video, I went on to show you that because of the partition structure, I wasn't able to extend the C drive. So that's exactly why I'm making this video. But before we start, I have to warn you that what I'm about to show you in this video is extremely delicate. If you mess up any part of what I'm about to show you, you could end up with a broken Windows installation and be forced to do a clean install of Windows from a USB flash drive again. So please, if you feel unsure about any of these steps I'm about to show you in this video, then rather don't follow through with it or ask someone to help you. Let's get started. Now, first off, let me navigate to disk management here and just show you what the problem is. So you can see we've got the C drive right here. And if I right click on it, I don't have the extend volume option. And that's because we have the recovery partition in between the C drive and this partition that we can use to reclaim our space back on the C drive. But then we also have a few megabytes of unallocated space here. And then we have the boot partition in between those two partitions. Now, your partition structure might not look exactly like this, but I don't want to make you too confused, so let's rather get into the step-by-step instructions. So first off, if you've come from my video about installing Windows without a USB flash drive, you will most probably also have the Windows installer partition. So what you can go ahead and do is just right-click on that and then delete volume. Just click on yes, so that you can get the space back as unallocated space. And right now we've got two unallocated space entries, but that's because this partition is in between these two partitions. So what we need to do is we need to delete the recovery partition and we need to delete the boot partition and then extend the C drive with the unallocated space. But after that, we have to recreate the recovery partition and also recreate the boot partition. Because if we don't have those, then our computer just won't boot at all. So to start off, do a search for CMD for command prompt, and then run that as administrator. Just accept any prompts if you do get any. And then in this command prompt window, the very first thing you have to type is reagent C space forward slash disable. So it should say that the operation was successful. Then next, we need to enter the disk part utility. So type disk part and press enter, and then it's going to launch disk part. Next, type the command list disk and run that. As you can see, I've only got disk 0, so we need to select disk 0. And you can just type SEL for select and then disk 0. And now disk 0 is the selected disk. If you have more disks in your computer, then you need to select the correct disk here, but I only have the one. Next, we need to type list part to list all of the partitions on that drive. So we can see that there are four partitions. So first, let's select the recovery partition. So that's partition number 2. So we're going to type SEL for select and then part for partition and then the number 2. Then it'll be selected. And then we have to type detail partition and press enter. So now we can get the details of that partition, and this is extremely important because we need to save this. So just open Notepad or anywhere where you can save these details of this partition. So I'm just going to select it all, press Ctrl C to copy, and then paste it inside of that document there. And I'll just say that partition 2 was recovery. So once you've done that, you need to delete the partition. So we need to type DEL for delete and then part for partition and then the word override. And if we run that, it successfully deleted the selected partition. Now you'll see that we don't have the recovery partition anymore, but we still have the boot partition that's stuck in between these two partitions, but we can't remove that right now. So what you need to do next is just select the C drive. Then you'll see you have the extend volume option because there's no partition that's stuck between these two anymore. So just right click, click on extend volume, click next. You can use all of the available space, click next again, and then click on finish. And now you've extended the C drive. Now we still need to create the recovery environment again. So just select the C drive, right click on it, and then click on shrink volume. And then for the amount of space to shrink it by, you can use 1000, which is 1 gig. So just click on shrink, and then you'll have 1 gig of unallocated space. Now next, just right click on it, select new simple volume, click on next, and just continue through the process until you're finished, and then you'll have this new volume partition. Now next, go back to the command prompt, type disk part again if you've left it, like I have. Then next, type list disk again, then select the disk, which is disk 0, and then list the partitions again. Now we need to select our 1 gig partition, which is partition 2. So type select partition 2 and press enter. Now we need to use the details that we got earlier. So first off, what we need is the type. So you need to select that and copy it. Go back to command prompt. And then you need to type set space dash ID equals, and then control V. So you can paste that ID and press enter. Then it should successfully set that partition ID. Next, you can go and copy the attribute with control C. And then you need to type the following command, which is GPT space, and then the word attributes equals, and then control V to paste, and then press enter to run that. And that should also run successfully. And now if we go back to disk management, you can see that we do have our C drive. We've got the 1 gig recovery partition, and then we've also still got the boot partition. Now, unfortunately, there's still this space of 529 megs unallocated, which I unfortunately couldn't get to the C drive as well. And I guess if you use some sort of partition tool, that you'll be able to do that. But using only Windows built-in tools, this is what I was able to do. But we're not done yet, because if I go to this PC, you'll notice that I have new volume here with the drive letter D. And that is the recovery partition we just created. But we don't want to see this partition when we go to this PC here. The issue is that drive letter doesn't show up in disk management. So once again, we have to use disk part. So just navigate to command prompt again. What you need to do now is just type the command list vol to list the volumes. And there you can see that volume 1 has drive letter D, and it's labeled as new volume. So all we're going to do is select volume 1. So volume 1 is now the selected volume. And then we're just going to type remove letter, and the letter is D, as we can see there. So I'm just going to type D and press enter, and then it successfully removed the drive letter from that partition. And if we go to this PC, you can see it doesn't show up in this PC anymore. Now, we're not quite done yet. First, we have to exit disk part. And then once we're back in the normal command prompt, then we need to enable the recovery partition again. So just type the command reagent C space forward slash enable, and then run that command. And now we can see that the operation was successful. And now we've got that space back that was stuck in between the recovery partition and the C drive. Like I said, it's unfortunate about this 529 megs that I've still got here, but you can't delete the boot partition the same way we did with the recovery partition. But at least you'll have some of that unallocated space back. And on your computer, it might even be that the boot partition is in front of the C drive and you don't even have this issue. But this setup is perfectly fine, because I was able to get back those 10 gigs that I was using for the Windows installation media. But if this video was helpful, please give it a like and consider subscribing to the channel. And as always, I just want to give a special shout out to all of my YouTube members. Thanks so much for your support. I really appreciate it. And I'll talk to all of you guys soon.